friends, good morning. How are you, all little intellectuals? All are fit and fine? Yes, all are fit because you are obeying all the instructions given by your parents, given by your teachers. Now, students, in this English class, today we will study, we will revise chapter A Visit to Jaipur of your English fairy book. In this chapter, first I will summarize this story of this chapter and then we will revise one by one all the exercises. It's a revision video, so students, let's start. This is a chapter, A Visit to Jaipur. In this chapter, Riya writes a letter to Raja. Who is Riya? Riya is a girl. Earlier, Riya and Raja, they both were studying in a same school in Kolkata. And then Raja was shifted to London with his family. And in this chapter, Riya writes a letter to Raja. And in this letter, she describes about her visit to Jaipur during her summer vacations. And she also wants to know that how Raja has spent his holidays. Now, in this chapter, in this letter, Riya describes that how she reached Jaipur with her family. So she writes that Raja, who is studying in Seven Oaks School now in London, and Riya writes that from Kolkata they started their journey. They took a flight to Delhi, and from Delhi airport they hired a taxi and they traveled by road and they reached Jaipur. Why they have hired taxi? Because they want to enjoy the road trip also. Why road trip is important? Because when you visit through a road, you can see the scenes outside, the standards, the houses, the cultures, everything you can see. So that is why their family decided to go through roads. And they reached Jaipur in the evening, so at night they took rest in the hotel which was already reserved by Riya's father, which was run by Rajasthan Tourism Board. And at night they took rest. In the morning they started their journey and they first visited Amber Fort. They hired a guide who told them about the history, about the way, how to reach that place. So first they visited Amber Fort and then they visited Hawa Mahal. Hawa Mahal, which was made by Raja Sawai Pratap Singh. It was built in 1799. And after Hawa Mahal, they took a lunch in a restaurant and they were very much surprised. Why? Because the food was served in a silverware. So, and interior was also very royal. So their family was very much surprised. And then the next day they visited City Palace and they visited Mansagar and also they visited Jantar Mantar. So this was the trip which she has described in the letter to her friend Raja, and he is studying now in Seven Oaks School. Now students, after summarizing the chapter, let's revise word meanings of this chapter. So word meanings, how many word meanings are there? There are, first word meaning is guide. What is the, who is called guide? Guide. Who is guide? Guide, a person who takes tourists around. Guide, a person who takes, guide is a person who takes tourists around. Guide कौन है? Guide who takes tourists around. Who is guide? When you go to visit any place, so guide, this person, he used to tell you about the way, how to reach there, that place, and also he tells you about the history of that place, historical importance of that place. So first is guide, and then second word meaning which is given in this chapter is honeycomb. Honeycomb, beehive. Honeycomb, honeycomb, beehive. students learn all these word meanings and then processions. What are processions? Processions, people or vehicles, people or vehicles, people or vehicles moving forward in a queue, moving forward in a queue, moving forward in a queue. Now, three word meanings are there in this chapter. First is guide, a person who takes tourists around. गाइड कौन होता है? वो आदमी जो टूरिस्ट्स को, यात्रियों को घुमाने ले जाता है, आसपास का एरिया दिखाता है. नेक्स्ट इज हनीकॉम्ब. हनीकॉम्ब बी हाइव हाउस ऑफ बीज. एंड देन नेक्स्ट इज प्रोसेशंस पीपल और व्हीकल्स मूविंग फॉरवर्ड इन अ क्यू. अ ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल और ग्रुप ऑफ व्हीकल्स दे मूव ऑन अ रोड एंड दे फॉलो अ क्यू. क्यू मीन्स लाइन. लोगों का और व्हीकल्स का समूह जो कैसे बढ़ता है? एक लाइन में आगे बढ़ता है. जुलूस, यू कॉल इट इन हिंदी जुलूस. सो दीज थ्री वर्ड मीनिंग स्टूडेंट्स लर्न. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज एक्सरसाइज विच इज गिवन ऑन पेज नंबर 39. सो लेट्स रिवाइज दिस एक्सरसाइज. You can open your notebook and books to revise with me. Next is fill in the blanks. Fill in the blanks. A, if this is exercise A. Riya was missing. Whom Riya was missing? Riya was missing Raja. She was missing Raja. And then second is Raja had joined. Which school Raja had joined in London? Seven Oaks School. Seven Oaks School. Raja has joined Seven Oaks School. Next is Riya's father wanted to take a road trip from where? From where they had taken road trip? From New Delhi. New Delhi to Jaipur. They had taken a road trip from New Delhi to Jaipur. Now next is the palace complex in the Amber Fort is divided into how many sections? Amber Fort was divided. It was divided into four sections. And they entered through Suraj Pole. Riya entered Amber Fort through which gate? Through Sun Gate, or you can say Suraj Pole. Suraj Pole. They entered Amber Fort through Suraj Pole. So these are fill-ups. Students learn these fill-ups. Now next is exercise. Tick the things that you should do and cross out the things that you should not do. वो चीजें जो आपको करनी चाहिए वो आपको टिक करना है और जो नहीं करनी चाहिए उन पर क्रॉस करना है. So here you will tick on I should maintain silence in and around the monument. When you go to see any monument, you should maintain silence there. And around that place, silence should be maintained. So tick on it. Next is I should stand in a queue to enter the monument. To enter into the monument, you should not rush. You should form a queue and stand in a queue and one by one enter in the monument. So tick on this. And then is I should not touch the monument. Very important students. Many people visit monument every day. So when everyone will touch the monument, the walls will get spoiled. So that is why it is said that you should not touch the monument. And then is I should throw plastic wrappers in the dustbin. Whenever you go to see any monument, you should always maintain the cleanliness. So you should, whatever you eat, always throw the wrappers in the dustbin. Don't throw it anywhere. Rest of the points you will cross it out. So next students, next is page number 40 exercise. So I'm going to rub this to write down the next exercise, which is given on page number 14. So here cross out the odd word. Odd word means all are similar words, out of them only one word is odd one. So you have to cross on that odd word. So in first, fabric, embroidery, material and cloth. Four words are there. So fabric, material and cloth are same and you have to cross on embroidery. So first is cross the odd one, cross out odd one. So first you will cross embroidery. Embroidery. And then next is adorn, decorate, beautify and bold. Adorn, decorate and beautify are similar words. Which word you will cross? You will cross bold. Cross bold. This exercise, it is given on children page number 40. This is given on page number 40. Then third is spot, venue, place and jewelry. So spot, venue and place are similar. You have to cross jewelry. Jewelry. And then next is tourist, traveler and visitor. They are similar words. So the odd one is monument. Write down monument. Monument. Next, fifth is connection, communication, contact and heritage. So connection, communication and contact are similar. The different odd one is heritage. So cross the word heritage. Sixth is culture, tradition, wildlife and history. So culture, tradition and history are similar words. Which is the odd one here? Wildlife. So cross it children. Wildlife. This is odd one here. So cross odd. Or cross the odd one out. In this exercise you will cross, put a cross on these words. Rest all words are similar in the same line. Now next is children, simple present tense and simple past tense. What is simple present tense? Simple present tense means the action which is happening now and the action which happens very often. Wo action jo, wo kaam jo abhi ho raha hai, ya wo kaam jo aksar hota hai. That is simple present tense. And simple past tense, the action which has happened in the past. Wo action jo bite hue samay mein ho chuka hai. So your next exercise is given on page number 41. Next exercise is given on page number 41. Fill in the blanks with the correct form of the words. Here in the bracket a word is given. In the fill up you have to fill the correct form of that word. So first is I dashed 2 kilometers yesterday. Two words are there in the bracket. So walk and walked. Which is suitable here? I walked 2 kilometers yesterday. Yesterday means simple past tense. The action which has happened in the past. So second form of verb will come. So here walked. W-A-L-K-E-D. Walked. Second is he dashed the old man after the accident. After the accident action happened in the past. So he helped. What will come here? Helped. Now next is children, earth dash around the sun. Now this is simple present tense. Why? Because this is a universal truth and it happens always. Earth never stops moving around the sun. So this is earth moves. Earth moves around the sun. Now fourth is my grandmother dash to uncle's house last Sunday. Last Sunday means action which has happened in the past. So went. Second form of verb went. Go, went, gone. So here went will come. Now fifth, we dash a film yesterday. Yesterday past action. Yesterday we watched. Second form of verb watched. W-A-T-C-H-E-D. We watched. And then sixth is she dash her car every weekend. The action which happens very often. So every weekend she washes her car. What will come here? Washes. W-A-S-H-E-S. She washes her car every weekend. Now next is write PR for simple present tense, and simply P you have to write the sentence which is in simple past tense. So first is, students, this is exercise B it is. So first is, Amit and Ritam play cricket every Sunday. This action they do very often. So it is present tense. So write down here P R. Now next is, I love vanilla ice cream. So this is also present tense. Simple present tense. Write down P R here. Now third is, the thirsty bird drank water from the lake. Thirsty bird drank. Drank here, verb is of past tense. So write down, children, P. P for past tense. Now fourth one. Kajal lives in Mumbai. Kajal lives in Mumbai. Simple present tense. Write down here, P, R. Fifth one, the snake hissed angrily at the mongoose. Hissed, past tense. So write down P. P means past tense. Sixth, Shikha sings for 2 hours every day. Every day she sings. Simple present tense. So write down P, R. P, R for simple present tense. Now students, move to next page. This is page number 42. Here what you have to do, you have to add comma to these sentences. Now this is a quotation, so here the speaker you have to separate from the quoted line. Now my mother said, put a comma after said. Then a man shouted, a comma after shouted. The postman said, put a comma after said. And then he wrote, put a comma after wrote. Then Isha said, put a comma after said. So here you have to use comma to what to do? You have to separate the speaker from the quoted, from his quotation. So after the speaker, you have to put comma. So here we have put comma, students. Now next is your synonyms. Synonyms for these words. This is given on page number 43. So I am rubbing this to do the last exercise. And then question answers are left. We will revise question answers also, students. So next is synonyms. You have to write here synonyms. Synonyms we are going to write here. Synonyms. This is given on page number 43. This exercise is given on page number 43. Synonyms. First is large. So large, its synonym is huge. Large, huge. And then second is patterns. Patterns means arrangement. Arrangement of lines, arrangement of anything. Arrangement. And then next is mild. Mild, moderate. Mild, moderate. What are synonyms, children? Synonyms means the words which have same meaning or similar words. So moderate. Then fourth is royal. Royal means royal, imperial. Royal, imperial, which belongs to royal family, king family. So royal, imperial. Now next we are going to revise question answers, and for that I am rubbing it to write down answers, students. You have already done this in your notebook, so open your notebook when you revise answers with me. Okay, so you should have question answers in front of you. Now let's revise question answers of chapter A Visit to Jaipur. So first is, where does Riya stay? What is the first question? Where does Riya stay? The answer is, Riya stayed in a tourist lodge run by Rajasthan Tourism Board. So write down the answer. You can write it in rough notebook to revise with me. Riya stayed in a tourist lodge. Riya stayed in a tourist lodge run by Rajasthan Tourism Board. Run by Rajasthan Tourism Board. Riya stayed in a tourist lodge run by Rajasthan Tourism Board. Now next question. What did the local guide show Riya and her family? Local guide ने Riya और उसकी family को क्या दिखाया? The local guide showed. Write down the answer. The local guide showed. What has he shown? Showed the Amber Fort. The Amber Fort and told about its history local guide ने क्या दिखाया? अंबर फोर्ट दिखाया और उसकी हिस्ट्री के बारे में बताया. The local guide showed the Amber Fort and told about its history. Local guide ने Amber Fort दिखाया और उसकी history के बारे में, इतिहास के बारे में बताया. Now next is who had built the Hawa Mahal? What does it look like from the outside? Who had built Hawa Mahal? The Hawa Mahal was built by किसने बनाया था? Hawa Mahal, students write H with capital. The Hawa Mahal was built by Maharaja Sawai Pratap. The Hawa Mahal was built by Maharaja Sawai Pratap Singh in 1799. So the Hawa Mahal was built by Maharaja Sawai Pratap Singh in 1799. Next part of the question is, what does it look like from the outside? So how does it look like? It looks like a honeycomb from the outside. It looks like a, write down, continue. It looks like a beautiful. It looks like a beautiful honeycomb. It looks like a beautiful honeycomb from the outside. It looks like a beautiful honeycomb from the outside. Now next question is, students, why was Riya in for a surprise at the restaurant? So the answer is, why was Riya in for a surprise? Riya was in for a surprise. Always start your answer from the question itself. Riya was in for a surprise. Why? Because the food was served. How the food was served? The food was served in silverware, and there was royal interiors on the wall and there was royal interiors on the wall. Now next answer 5, last answer is list the things Riya had for lunch. You have to write here the things which Riya had in lunch. So Riya had प्याज की कचौरी एंड देन शी हैड गट्टे की सब्जी रिया हैड प्याज की कचौरी गट्टे की सब्जी एंड राइस अलोंग विद बटर मिल्क फॉर द लंच. सो व्हाट डज रिया हैड रिया हैड प्याज की कचौरी गट्टे की सब्जी एंड राइस अलोंग विथ बटर मिल्क फॉर द लंच. So we have revised students full chapter, A Visit to Jaipur. Learn all the exercises, practice it by writing in rough notebook. So that's all for today students. If you want latest updates of my videos, so please subscribe my channel. So that's all for today. Bye bye students. Have a good day.